So it's a new month and a new monthly dragon. The legendary Torch Dragon is the new dragon of the month and can be bred for the whole of October 2017. Today I'll be giving you the 5 best combinations you can use to get a hold of this powerful dragon. The Torch Dragon's elements are legendary, light as his secondary, and fire as his third unlocked element, making him a strong dragon that can damage all 3 opponent dragons at once. So the elements required to breed the Torch Dragon this month are the fire, metal, earth, and plant elements. There are tons of different combinations you could use, but I've cut it down to the best 5. The very best combination you can use is the orange plus metal dragons, and the reason I'm saying this is the best combo is because this doesn't use any limited time dragons, which means that everyone pretty much can use this combination as long as they have the metal dragon available. And so if we go onto the breeding calculator, breeding these two together means that there's 5 different possible outcomes, with the longest breeding time being on the cyborg dragon, which is a really low breeding time. 5 different possible outcomes is like nothing, but I can't stress enough, this combo is extremely easy to get a hold of. The orange dragon is an easy dragon to breed as well, and I have done a guide on him, so if you want the easiest and one of the most optimal combos to use, this is by far your best bet. And so the second combination I'm going to be showing you today is the Gentleman plus Fire Dragon. You can also switch out the Gentleman for something like a Golem or another dragon as well that has the same elements, and it will do the same thing. So technically, this is by far the very best combo that you can use optimally, and they only give you 4 other possible outcomes, which is insane. And this gives you about a 4.5% chance to breed the legendary Torch Dragon, with the highest breeding time being on the orange dragon, the other dragons having a 2-hour breeding time, 1 hour 30 minutes, and a 6-hour breeding time respectively. So unless you breed the orange, the others are going to be able to be reset like pretty much straight away. But the only issue is all of the dragons, like the Gentleman, Golem, and that, they're only limited time dragons. So they're not dragons that you can actively breed. So you already have to have one of these dragons available to use this combo. And then a third pair that I'm going to suggest, which is another one that uses limited time dragons, or the Heavenly Dragon that was just on sale, is the Heavenly plus Plan. And obviously you can swap out the Heavenly Dragon for a couple of other dragons as well with the same types. And if we scroll down, another breeding pair with only 4 possible outcomes, and again the orange dragon having the longest breeding time at 16 hours, and this is again going to give you about a 4.5% chance to breed that legendary Torch Dragon, but again, limited time dragons, so not a breeding pair that anybody can use. But if you don't have any epic dragons, don't quite have the orange dragon yet, then no worries there, because we do also have 2 more combos that use common dragons, so very easy combos. First one being the lava plus venom dragons here, and if we scroll down, there's 6 different possible outcomes, the longest one again being on that orange dragon at 16 hours. So this one's going to give you about a 3.5 to 4% chance to breed the Torch, so not too much different, but obviously still pretty low chances overall. But the thing about this combo is, because if you do get the orange dragon with this combo, you can keep trying to breed the lava and venom, and then when you get a hold of the orange dragon, you can switch it up to the first combo that I showed you, so you can swap to that better breeding pair midway through the month or whenever you get a hold of him, which is pretty nifty. And then the final one I'm going to suggest, again with common dragons, is the Ceremony plus Minotaur. And obviously for these 2 combos you could also use the uncommon versions of these dragons, because they have the same elements. As long as you have the 4 required elements in here, you will have a chance at breeding him. And with the Ceremony plus Minotaur, there's seven different possible outcomes. So this is going to give you about a 3% chance to breed the Torch Dragon, and again, still the chance to breed the Orange Dragon. So this Orange Dragon is just literally everywhere we go today, but use any of these five combos, you'll have a good shot. The breeding time for the Torch Dragon is the same as all legendary dragons, a breeding time of 2 days normally, or it's reduced to 1 day and 14 hours if you have VIP active at the time. This makes it extremely easy to tell whether you bred this cute little legendary or not, since the timer is so long. But which level dragon should you use to breed the Torch Dragon? Well, for breeding legendary dragons, I suggest using level 15 plus dragons. The higher the levels of your breeding dragons, the higher the odds are of you breeding the Torch this month, but 15 works well as sort of a minimum level. But no matter how high you level your dragons, there is still only a low chance to breed the Torch Dragon, and it will probably take you many, many tries before you successfully breed him. But you do have a whole month to keep trying, so no need to panic just yet. Of course, the combinations I mentioned aren't the only ones out there, but according to the DML Wiki and breeding calculators, they are by far the most optimal breeding pairs you can use. I would suggest checking out the sites yourself too, since they are very useful, and the DML Wiki is updated extremely frequently with new tables and guides. But that is pretty much everything you should need to know about breeding the Torch Dragon this month. I wish you the very best of luck. You are gonna need it. And I'll leave you with a couple of fights I did with Aaron the Torch Dragon earlier.